Okay, so today we're looking at how to write the essay. The essay is part of the synoptic paper. So in paper one, you've got topics 1 to 4. In paper two of A2, you've got topics 5 to 8. And in the third paper, you've got questions across the whole syllabus and the essay question. Now you'll know that the essay question is 25 marks. That's massive. That's enough to make or break your A level. When you have the paper three and you're given your essay titles, you're given 2 essay titles and you're able to choose. Now the best way to make progress with your essay is to understand how it is marked. We use a rubric like this one, and I'll put a photograph of this on this video later. But we start off in brackets 1 to 5. And we look at your essay, we read it through, and we decide, if it's in 1 to 5, can it move to 6 to 10 on the criteria? So in 1 to 5, one of the things that it wants you to do is have A-level content. Now that might seem really obvious, but let's think about that for a moment. If you've got 2 essay titles, one is on perhaps carbon dioxide, or carbon recycling, whatever, and the other one's on DNA, you might choose the carbon one because you might think, well, that's easier to write than writing the DNA. But actually, it's not, because what you've got to do is show that you have been to A-level class. You've got to produce an essay that somebody else, a lay person who's not a scientist, could write. So most people, if they're well read, if they listen to the news, they read the newspaper, would be able to write an essay on carbon and carbon dioxide in the atmosphere. But not many people would be able to write an essay on DNA. And so actually, the easier one for you to achieve marks on is the one on DNA. So the first bracket is, does it contain A-level content? You're trying to show that you're not just a good Key Stage 4 student, that you've actually been to A-level class. And so that's why as soon as you get an essay on something like DNA, and you can talk about DNA helicase or polymerase, which isn't included in Key Stage 4, which most people don't know about, you're onto a winner, and that's the essay you want to choose. Okay, so you've chosen your essay title, and you're clearly able to talk about A-level content. So again, in photosynthesis, you might talk about ribulose biphosphate. Who else knows about that? You need to have been to A-level class to know about that. So we're then looking, can we move into the 6 to 10 category for marks? To move into this category, you need to have chosen at least 5 different areas of the specification. So for example, if you were writing an essay on proteins, you wouldn't just write about enzymes, because that's only one topic. You would choose 5 across the specification. You might choose immunology, you might choose enzymes, you might choose muscle contraction, you might choose protein channels in membranes, and so on. So you need to show that you've been to A-level class for the full 2 years and you know the whole specification. If you write 4, you cannot move past 5 marks. If you write 1, 2, 3, or 4 different areas, you can't move into this. Now with my year 13s this year, this was their common mistake. They continued to write too much information for each area. They ran out of time and they would never manage to write about 5 different areas. So their marks were always less than 5. And so one of the other things that will help you cover 5 different areas is if you use appropriate terminology. Again, when you use A-level terminology, instead of writing a sentence, you're able to write 1 or 2 words. Clonal, selection, crossing over. Any of these terms will help you cut down the amount you write and give you more time to cover the 5 areas. And so we're now looking, we've read your essay and it's in the 6 to 10 marks. can it move into the 11 to 13? So what we're looking for now is that each of these five areas are related. You can't just write five random paragraphs. You need to have a way of linking them together. So you might talk about enzymes, and then you might talk about how some enzymes are channel proteins, and you might then talk about channel proteins for the whole paragraph. You might then talk about how channel proteins are related to muscle contraction and the influx of ions for muscle contraction to happen. So they need to be linked in some way. If they're linked in some way, we can then award you and push you into the 11 to 15 category. If they're not linked, you can't get more than 10. And it could be a fabulous essay that contains A-level content that covers perhaps four areas, but you're not getting any more marks. Now bear in mind, the exam board have said that the mean mark is 13 out of 25 for this essay, with a standard deviation of 4. So that means 95% of the population who take this exam get a mark between 9 and 17. So just imagine if you're able to push your mark higher up. You know that the grade boundaries between an A, a B, a C are very, very small, and this essay can be the winner for you. It can make you or it can break you. Okay, so we've now read your essay. It's got A-level content. I can tell that Mr. Mance or Mrs. Hunter didn't write it because you had to come to class. It's got five areas across the syllabus, and those five areas link and flow from one to the other. Fantastic. We're now moving into the 16 to 20 bracket. And what we're looking for here is that there's an underlying theme that runs all the way through these paragraphs. Now, the easy theme to pick in biology is survival, because everything about you and your body and your biochemical makeup is for you to survive. So what we're going to do is we're going to link every single bit, whatever your essay is, to survival. So for instance, we talk about enzymes. Well, without enzymes, you don't lower your activation energy. You can't live in a range of different environments. You therefore have to take on behavioral adaptations because of the temperature changes around you. If we think about muscle contraction, without muscle contraction, we're not able to move away from harmful stimuli and towards more favorable stimuli. And so all of these things can be linked to survival. So to move into the 16 to 20 bracket, what we're looking at is that there is a theme. And the easy theme in biology is survival. Okay, so we're now on the last one. We've got all of these things, and we're able to keep pushing the quality of our essay higher and higher. Can it get into the final category? What do you need for that? Well, amongst other things, the key requirement for this is reading beyond the specification. Now, what I tell my students in year 13 to do is to choose something that can span lots of topics. So, in this book, what's really good about it is that beyond the specification is highlighted with this plus sign here. So, for instance, this example, which is about immunological comparisons of proteins, we've got DNA we can talk about, we've got proteins we can talk about, immunology, survival. There's plenty of ways that you could take that one thing and put it into lots of essays. So if I was you, I would try and choose maybe five different areas beyond the specification that you can write about with confidence and then include it in your essay. Okay. When you do the essay, you've got about 33 minutes in total to produce your essay. And that includes making a plan. You have to make a plan. The reason why is because otherwise you'll talk about one particular area in far too much detail. You've got to decide which bits of the five areas you're going to talk about are you going to zoom in the detail. I would suggest that you choose the areas that really highlight the A-level content, i.e. a person from outside can't do, or a really good Key Stage 4 student can't do. You have to do a plan. In that plan, you can show the bit that you're going to add, whether it is beyond the specification. And then when the examiner is marking your essay, they're going to see that and they're going to look out for it and they're going to know that you know how the essay is marked and that you've included all those key features. Beyond that, the essay is marked holistically, and that means they're looking for a best fit. So you might have beyond the specification, but you might have skipped maybe linking your paragraphs, and so that will bring your mark further down this end of the rubric.